Over 2 trillion galaxies in the observable universe now face extinction from a force that could be greater than gravity itself. A strange pull is stripping galaxies of their very substance and enriching itself. Is there a predator in our universe? Ever since humans have had eyes, we've been looking up at the gleaming stars in awe. Some say the universe is empty, others that there is something beyond our world. But the vast emptiness of space isn't empty at all. It's crowded, filled with countless objects from the tiniest atoms to giant planets, asteroids, and comets. Space is not only crowded, it is also riddled with bizarre and downright weird phenomena, things that don't fit into our understanding of how the universe works. NASA has telescopes that orbit around other planets, probing their surfaces and studying their atmospheres. But there's still so much about these places that scientists can't explain. There's always the chance of finding something you don't expect, like ultra-massive black holes, oil and gas on Saturn's moon, and alcohol-spewing comets. Never has it been seen that a galaxy dragged matter from its faraway neighbors. Do galaxies really die when their stars stop forming, or is there something out there far beyond science's understanding, pulling everything on its path to gain dominance in the universe? There's a lot to cover regarding this mysterious phenomenon, but perhaps the best place to start is at the beginning. Here's a tale of a galaxy preying on its neighbors in the most unusual galactic cannibalism ever recorded. Of the 4 forces of nature, gravity is the weakest, but in space, gravity holds the entire universe together, forming an unbreakable bond between the planets separated by millions of miles. The Milky Way, a massive collection of dust, gas, and stars, houses our solar system. At its center lies a supermassive black hole with millions to billions of times the mass of the Sun. This black hole is so powerful that it outshines all of the stars in their galactic disks. Nothing escapes a black hole. Objects pulled into a black hole never return because the gravity is too strong. But black holes may not be the most powerful thing out there. In 1970, astronomers discovered that our Milky Way was moving through space in the direction of the constellation of Centaurus at about 6,000 kilometers per second. This anomaly propelled further studies into space. With advancements in science and technology, scientists developed the Parkes Radio Telescope to examine the Milky Way with a new level of sensitivity. Astronomers gained an excellent look at nearby galaxies and a clearer understanding of the Milky Way's composition. To understand the anomaly, astronomers studied the motion of our galaxy and other galaxies in our supercluster over a region of hundreds of millions of light years across the universe. These galaxies can't be seen above and below the zone of avoidance. Results show that the Milky Way wasn't the only thing being pulled by this unexplainable force. It turns out there's something outside the Milky Way which now moves at an astounding 1.3 million miles per hour toward the Centaurus, a darker area that scientists are yet to explore called the Zone of Avoidance, and lies in the direction of the constellation Centaurus. The major challenge astronomers face with the Zone of Avoidance is overdensity. Present on that side of the Milky Way is an enormous confluence of stars and star clusters, tons of gases and space dust obstructing the light, which would typically come from that direction, hence impossible to study. Towards the direction of Centaurus, scientists observed an unknown force of tremendous magnitude, sitting between 150 and 250 million light-years away from the Milky Way, the Great Attractor, so named because it pulls everything towards it, including our galaxy, the Milky Way. Scientists speculate that the Great Attractor houses a localized concentration of mass millions of times more massive than the Milky Way. The Milky Way and the neighbouring Andromeda galaxy are moving toward this concentrated mass, identified as a local group of galaxies. This local group of galaxies is located in the Virgo supercluster, which also houses the Virgo cluster. The Great Attractor might have formed in the early universe due to the primordial density fluctuations with smaller objects like galaxies forming around it through gravitational collapse. Its center lies about 147 million light-years away from the Earth and steadily pulls several galaxies towards its center. As you know, space remains a mystery and discoveries pop up as research deepens. Astronomers discovered a large supercluster of galaxies near the center of the Great Attractor and named it the Norma Cluster. It is about 222 million light-years from the Earth, with an estimated mass of 1,000 trillion solar masses. In 2005, a team of astronomers engaged in an X-ray survey called the Clusters in the Zone of Avoidance CSER project. Their findings brought up more questions concerning this galaxy-eating force. Apparently, the Great Attractor has only about a tenth of the mass initially estimated. The Malmquist bias is the scientific explanation for the miscalculated mass of the Great Attractor. It is an effect in observational astronomy which allows brighter objects to be detected. The farther the object is from Earth, the dimmer they appear. Hence, only the shiniest objects can be observed at a greater distance, creating a false trend of increasing intrinsic brightness with distance. The Malmquist bias has been a challenge in astronomy. Scientists often estimate faraway objects closer to Earth than they are. This also explains why some regions in space appear to have more galaxies than others, and the Great Attractor appeared to have more galaxies than it does. It is likely that the Great Attractor is a facade or doesn't exist, but points towards something deeper and more mysterious. The mass of the Great Attractor cannot generate the gravitational pull to drag other galaxies. It must be that there is something stronger than the Great Attractor. Suppose the Great Attractor is not responsible for the increased motion of these galaxies toward their possible destruction. What is pulling the center of the Virgo supercluster? With this information, astronomers began digging deeper into the Great Attractor's mystery power and found the answer they never expected. The CSER team reported a superior cluster behind the Great Attractor, lying around 500 million light-years away. They called it the Shapley Supercluster. The Shapley Supercluster is the largest concentration of galaxies in the observable universe and lies 650 million light-years from the Earth. It comprises approximately 20 large clusters and more than 8,000 galaxies in the constellation of Centaurus. It is the largest structure within a billion light-years of our Milky Way and boasts a total mass more than 10 million billion times that of the Sun. Harlow Shapley had long observed the Shapley supercluster in the early 90s, but it wasn't until 2013 that astronomers could see what the cluster was about. ESA's Planck satellite, launched in 2009, captured snapshots of some galaxy clusters and superclusters while scanning the sky for the oldest cosmic light. The image was produced by reconstructing the Sunyaev-Zeldovich effect from the Planck frequency maps. The largest pink blobs of X-rays identify the two galaxy clusters in the Shapley supercluster. Abel 3558 on the right and Abel 3562 on the left, and a couple of smaller clusters between them. Directly opposite the Shapley supercluster, astronomers found an overdensity of galaxies. The dipole repeller repels celestial bodies, pushing them towards the Shapley supercluster, which, aided by gravity, pulls them toward its center. Due to this, the dipole repeller has likely become devoid of matter and is constantly pushing objects away from itself since it's under-dense. At the same time, the overdense Shapley supercluster continues to devour galaxies. Or so we thought. Professor Matthew Collis of the Australian National University thinks otherwise. He has calculated the gravitational force of the Shapley cluster, the Virgo cluster, and the Great Attractor, and they don't add up. According to him, the Milky Way should be moving at 31 miles per second and not 1.3 million miles per hour. He attributes this force to something he called the Vela supercluster. Collis claims that this insanely massive supercluster, previously hidden by the Milky Way's dust and gas, could be the biggest concentration of galaxies in the universe. The Vela supercluster lies about 870 million light-years, with a total mass of about 1,000 times the mass of the Milky Way galaxy. But the Vela supercluster's size has yet to be confirmed, so we cannot say the Vela supercluster is devouring our galaxies. Thanks to the CSIRO Parkes Radio Telescope, 883 galaxies within the zone of avoidance were observed at about 250 million light-years away from Earth. Each galaxy comprised billions of stars, capable of exerting a massive gravitational pull on our Milky Way and the nearby galaxies. But this doesn't explain why the Milky Way is moving at such incredible speeds, or if it can be stopped. Scientists think the unexplained expansion of the universe is caused by dark energy and speculate that only something equally as dark can overcome it, thus debunking the idea that a supercluster is devouring the galaxies. Instead, they associate this force with a mysterious, undiscovered force called dark flow. However, the distribution of matter in the observable universe cannot account for the concept of dark flow.